Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to quickly show you how to make a simple but powerful logo of your face and name. Open a photo of your face or someone else's face that you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The first step is to separate the face from its background by making a selection around the face. For this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, drag it over your subject to select it. To remove areas outside the subject, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. Once you make your selection, click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to your subject. We'll make a new layer below it by Control-clicking or Command-clicking the New Layer icon. We'll fill it with black, but first, make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white, respectively. If they aren't, press D on your keyboard. Since your foreground color is black, press Alt or Option plus Delete. We'll convert our visible image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, Shift-click the top layer to make it active as well, and click the icon at the upper right corner. Click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. For this example, I'll blur it 10 pixels, but feel free to experiment with the amount, which will determine the amount of detail your portrait will have. For now, type in anywhere from 5 to 10 pixels. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Threshold. Keep the default threshold level at 128. If your portrait is too simple, double-click Gaussian Blur, and when the effect window opens, lower the amount of blur. Make a new layer below the active layer and fill it with black. Since the logo is going to extend past our visible image, we need to add more space around it. To do this, go to Image and Canvas Size. Change the parameters to percent. I'll type in 130 for the width and height to give me ample space to work with. To see your entire document, press Ctrl or Command 0. Then, fill the rest of the background with black. To remove white areas of the portrait that we don't want, zoom into that area by pressing Z on your keyboard to open your Zoom tool and drag over that area. Make the top layer active and make a new layer above it. Open your Pencil tool and Pencil Picker. We'll adjust the size in a moment. Make sure its hardness and opacity are both 100%. Then press Enter or Return. To adjust the pencil size, first make sure the Caps Lock key is off, and then press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Draw over the white areas you want to hide. Then fit your document back onto your canvas. We'll convert our visible image into a smart object by shift-clicking the bottom layer to make all the layers active and clicking Convert to Smart Object. Make a new layer below it and fill it with white. Since our background color is white, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Make the top layer active. Let's zoom into it a bit by pressing Ctrl or Command and the plus key on your keyboard once or twice. Open your Polygon tool. At the top, type in 3 for the sides. We'll use this amount for the purposes of this example, but feel free to experiment later if you want. Pick Shape. If you're using version CS5 or earlier, the Shape icon is here. The fill is black, and the stroke is empty. Go to the center of your portrait and press and hold Shift as you drag the tool straight up. Don't release Shift if you want to position the shape. Add the space bar with Shift as you drag the shape over, then release. Control-click or Command-click the shape to make a selection of it. Since we have its selection, we can delete the layer. Either press the Delete key on your keyboard, or on earlier versions of Photoshop, drag it to the trash. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the portrait. Next, we'll add a thin outline frame around the shape. Click the Fill box and click the white icon with the red diagonal line. This makes the fill empty. Click the Stroke box and click the black box. I'll type in 10 pixels. This will make it have a black stroke with a 10 pixel width. Place your cursor on the center and press and hold Shift as you drag the tool straight up. Don't release Shift yet. To position it as you did before, add the space bar as you drag it down until the sides are equidistant to the sides of the solid triangle. Then release. To move your document on your canvas, press V to open your Move tool and press the space bar as you drag your document. We're ready to add text. Open your Horizontal Type tool and your list of fonts. I'm using Decotech TL Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in my video's description below or project files. I'll make its size temporarily around 87 points, sharp, and center alignment. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. In this layer, we'll place our text. Click below your portrait and type out your text. To position it, open your Move tool and center it. If you want to adjust your text size, open your Transform tool and go to a corner. When you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. Then press Enter or Return. If you want to finesse the size and/or position of the portrait inside the shape, make your portrait active and click the chain link icon to unlink the layer and the layer mask. Doing this allows us to resize and reposition either of them independently of the other. Open your Transform tool. If the Transform's bounding box goes beyond your visible canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner and drag it out or in. Then zoom into it again, and if you want to, drag it to the center. Next, I'll show you how to place your logo onto a black background. Control-click or Command-click the thumbnail of your shape layer to make a selection of it. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. The reason we're going to contract it is to prevent a thin white fringe from surrounding our logo. Contract it 2 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. We'll place all of our layers into a folder by making your top layer active and shift-clicking the bottom layer to make all the layers active. Then press Ctrl or Command G. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the folder. Make a new layer below it and fill it with black. Lastly, let's crop off the excess background surrounding our logo as well as size it. Open your Crop tool and Crop Preset List. Click Width, Height, and Resolution. For the width and height, I'll type in 1000px for pixels, and for the resolution, I'll type in 300 pixels per inch. Fit your crop's bounding box onto your canvas. Go to a corner and drag it in until your logo is cropped to your liking. Then, click the check mark at the top. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.